to stop again. Stay with us on EA TV. And welcome to St Mary's here on the south coast of England. I'm Derek Ray, joined for commentary by former England international Lee Dixon, and looking forward to bringing you action from the Premier League coming right up. It is Southampton taking on Chelsea.
Yeah, thank you, Derek. Lovely to be here. I can't wait for this one. A nice quick tempo from both sides would be ideal for me.
Well, it could be on for him here. Is it going to be? Oh, the keeper making sure that was pushed well away from danger. It is to be a throw-in. Options in the middle. And the keeper was always likely to do his job under no pressure. And here's how it looks for Southampton. Kyle Walker-Peters plays with Ryan Bertrand in the fullback positions. And the story in attack is one of a strike partnership.
Well, Derek, they're not happy. Ref is taking the brunt of this.
Oh, big chance.
Well, here's the table.
He's got to score. A goal in the early stages. Precisely what they had been planning. The opening goal of the game then. Throw-in forthcoming. They've regained possession. It is a decent-looking attack here. Now, based on that challenge, you wouldn't be at all surprised if the referee reaches for his pocket. There will be a booking for Thiago Silva here.
Yeah, the Brazilian's got no complaints over that decision.
A header it was, but a pretty straightforward save, Lee.
Well, it's an easy header, Derek, and he made it look really difficult.
And they'll get ready for the throw-in. Potential danger here. Great block from Thiago Silva. And over comes the corner. Given away by Chelsea. Chance to do damage. Knows he's got to react. Mount. It's with Hakim Ziyech. Ziyech. Fine cross into the middle. Just the clearance that was needed. It's not a great margin for error when it comes to hitting it on the volley, Lee.
No, it's a really difficult technique, but it's worth a go. He had a go and he failed, but he'll get another chance.
Walker-Peters. Ward-Prowse. Ings. Oh, what an opportunity! Well, he saw the whites of the keeper's eyes. The whites of his outstretched gloves. Great goalkeeping.
Well, he's denied a certain goal there. Great reflexes from the keeper.
It didn't happen for them. Spot on with that tackle. And unable to keep possession. Reece James. Attacking possibilities for Chelsea. Giroud. Two-goal cushion now, and the lead fully merited.
Goal
so, 2-0 now.
Number 18, Olivier Giroud.
And intercepted it. James. Not an especially strong challenge. Thou shalt not pass, was the message delivered. Throw-ins given. Walcott. And Chelsea moving the ball forward. What can they... And he scored not once, but twice. They simply cannot stop him. And no wonder he's enjoying
goal
himself.
For Chelsea.
Well, the ball is moving again, and Chelsea are quite simply running away with this. And the whistle is sound. So back in business here, and Chelsea dominating the proceedings in the first half of this game. Will we see a similar pattern in the second 45? And after that fantastic effort, it's gone out for a throw-in. Timo Werner, in with a chance. It has to be, surely. His third goal of the match, and you cannot argue with that.
Well, he's tearing this defence apart. They can't cope with him. Well, here it is again, and it's all about the pace in transition. They were so quick to get out from the back, and it all leads to a 2-v-1 on the keeper, which he really doesn't have any chance with. It's a great team goal. They've been bossing this game up to now.
Goal for Chelsea.
And this is turning into something of a rout. 4-0. Olivier Giroud. Chance to finish. Oh, there it is! It's one goal after another, and it speaks to the quality of that performance. My goodness, it's so one-sided. 5-0 in this match.
Chelsea enjoying the bulk of possession here. Really started to dictate the tempo of this game now. And they're creating chances as well. I'm not sure their opponents seem to have the answer, to be honest. They can't seem to get a foothold in this game.
Forget, we have more live action from the Premier League coming up here on EA TV. It's Southampton facing Burnley.
Yeah, Derek, should be a great atmosphere there. It's one I would be tuning in for if I wasn't there with you.
Aware of the threat, solving the problem. Ings. Really nice ball. Dominguez. And space here on the flank. Giroud. Well, nothing comes of it. Well, they've decided to make a change. Nicolas Dominguez. I'm sure, you know, he wishes he could have that header back.
Well, in that position, you should think he's going to score, but it's really a poor effort with his head.
And a friendly reminder that we have more action from the Premier. Well, it could be on for him here. And it's a double for him in this game. No way for the opposition to contain him. And no wonder he's off celebrating.
Well, here it is again. He does so well to slip past his man, left him stranded. And he had choices of what type of finish to apply. And bang, he goes for the smash. Lovely goal.
Well, if there were any lingering doubts about the outcome, surely they removed. Chelsea did well to regain control of it. Neves. And he's broken free.
It was well stopped. Well, positioning is everything for a goalkeeper, and he was in a good position then.
And intercepts again. Conviction in the challenge. It should be a goal. We're really being spoiled. This is attacking football at its finest.
Number 18, Olivier Giroud.
We're underway again. This game very much over as a contest. Ings. To win possession back. Committed challenge. And to go. Ings. It was a risky challenge, but brilliantly executed. Havertz. Olivier Giroud. Azpilicueta now.
Well, he stopped them just when they looked menacing. And the electronic board delivers the news. 2 minutes of stoppage time.
The final whistle then, and one piece of business taken care of. They are guaranteed to be playing Champions League football next season. And who knows, Lee? Today on EA TV. Stamford Bridge is the venue. I must say the weather has certainly cooperated. It's beautiful here today. I'm Derek Ray, and joining me here on the commentary box is Lee Dixon. And with the Premier League season about to reach its conclusion, we're just minutes away from kickoff time. It is Chelsea, and they take on Sheffield United.
Well, what a season it's been, Derek. It's had absolutely everything. Drama at both ends of the table, spectacular goals, and plenty of entertainment too. The players need to finish the season off strongly. We're looking forward to a great game here.
On the back of that particular challenge, will the referee let the matter rest there? Referees like to manage the game just as much as players do, but today it is an early yellow card, and we'll see what effect that has on the match.
Well, it'll have a big effect, especially on the player, and also the defenders around that.
Must score! Tremendous block.
And offside, unfortunately.
Getting news of a goal in the Liverpool match, Alan.
It's a goal for Aston Villa. 10 minutes played, 1-0.
Thanks as ever for the update, Alan. Giroud. Showing patience as well as persistence in the build-up. Chance maybe. Oh, cleared off the line. Alert defending. Corner it is for Chelsea. And firing it into the area. That's a routine take. Now, will the keeper have to pay the price for that mistake? It might be the moment to get them ahead. A goal! 1-0! A fully deserved advantage based on what we've seen.
Goal for Chelsea.
The opening goal of the game then.
Olivier Giroud.
Continues his run. Giroud. Real chance. And another one. Two quick goals. Will it turn out to be the two-punch knockout? So 2-0 now. Olivier Giroud. Showing good defensive judgment. No, not the best challenge. Lundstrom.
Chelsea really have been dominating possession, really starting to dictate the tempo of this game now, and they're creating chances as well. I'm not sure.
Opportunity it is. Well, the ball is moving again, and Chelsea are quite simply running away with this. And news of a goal in the West Brom game, Alan.
It's a goal for West Bromwich Albion. 30 minutes played, 1-0.
Alan McAnally with his finger on the pulse. Azpilicueta. Giroud. He'll be a bit annoyed to have lost the ball. Fleck. Well, let's see if something comes of this. Well, they've given him too much space. Still possibilities. Flag raised for offside. Azpilicueta. It's with Hakim Ziyech.
Thiago Silva. Reece James. And a goal has gone in the Liverpool match. Alan McInerney.
It's a goal. Oh, in with a chance.
And disappointingly, he got completely underneath that.
Well, here's a coaching tip. Long range shot, lean back equals over the bar.
I always listen to your coaching tips, Lee. And apologies to Alan McInerney for having to cut him off. Just to confirm, Liverpool have scored in that match. And it's now even Steven, 1-1. Ziyech. It's with Giroud. Werner. Not a huge chunk of added time. 1 minute. Jack Rodwell. And the first 45 minutes have come and gone. Two teams have switched around and are ready now for the second half. In a position from which they could potentially do a bit of damage here. Corner conceded, it came off the defender. And the short option preferred.
Well, here's the replay. It's a clever play to take the short corner and create a new angle for the cross. And what a great finish as well. Good connection with the ball, leaving the goalkeeper absolutely no chance. Fantastic goal.
And this is turning into something of a rout. 4-0. A goal has been scored in the Crystal Palace match. Alan McInerney with details.
It's a second goal for Crystal Palace.
Might be a chance here. My goodness, it's so one-sided. 5-0 in this match. And unfortunately, we did have to cut Alan McInerney short there. To clarify, Palace have found the net in that match, and they hold the aces presently, leading 2-1. How can he take them on and beat them? Well, they keep working away, looking for passing lanes. Well, decent effort, but not troubling the keeper too much. Well, it is an occasion never to be missed, and you'll see it live with us right here on EA TV, the Champions League final. It's Chelsea versus Paris Saint-Germain.
Well, as finals go, Derek, they don't come much bigger than that one, do they? Champions League final. Never managed to get to one myself, but I've watched a few, and I'll be watching that one with you, Derek.
Well, options at the back post here. A glut of goals. 5-1 it is. Someone has found the net at Anfield. Who exactly? Alan McInerney.
It's a second goal for Liverpool. 66 minutes played. 3-2.
Ziyech. Crucial intervention just then amid impending danger. We're now inside the final 20 minutes of the game. Olivier Giroud gives it a go. Well, it wasn't a simple save to make. And Chelsea win the corner. Played into the centre of the box. And the defender takes care of business. Werner. Giroud. Timely intervention. And across the touchline, so a throw in here. They will now make use of the substitutes bench. Max Lowe. Well, it could be on for him here. He knew he had to make the tackle, and did. 10 minutes left for play in this match. Oh, in with a chance! And the goalkeeper covered a lot of ground to push that away from danger. That is how to apply the pressure. The quality of pass needs to be a bit better. quickly to take on the shot. Oh, good technique in terms of how he struck it. Brian. Jack Rodwell. Berger with it. Gaetano Castrovilli. And possession given away. Real chance. Oh, there it is! It's one goal after another, and it speaks to the quality of that performance.
For Chelsea, number 18, Olivier Giroud.
So the final whistle now, it goes down as a victory for Chelsea, to the delight of their fans around the world, Lee.
Well, being potent up front gives you a great chance in any game, and they were certainly that today. Sharp, clinical, and exciting to watch for sure.
This is it, the Champions League final. They are underway. Who will be crowned club kings of Europe? Mount. Werner. And in with a real chance. Well, a top-notch piece of defensive judgment. It is the game that the world truly focuses on. To jump in front. Going to be angry with himself, Lee, having failed to take that chance so early in the game.
Well, the first chance of a game is important, but the first goal, sometimes it comes, you're not expecting it.
Well, we used to think of Timo Werner as the classic counter-attacking forward, but he's improved his game, better now in tight spaces. Lee, what do you expect to see from him?
Well, he's scoring goals for fun. It's become a habit for him, a lovely habit to have, mind. Superb form, brimming with confidence. Just one goal away from the record now. Good luck to him.
Verratti. Now Neymar. A super tackle and they've won possession. Oh, big chance. Can he convert? On his own, with only the keeper to beat, and still he's missed it.
Well, he had one thought, power. He should have thought composure.
Verratti. Intercepting it intelligently. Oh, great vision. Well, offside anyway, albeit a tight one. Well, Thiago Silva has been on the back pages of many a newspaper in recent days. Facing his former club today, it was always, to a large extent, going to be about him. And you have to say, the reception he's received has been a good one, Lee.
Yeah, it has, really has. He'll have mixed feelings today, though, Derek. On one hand, he'll remember the good old times here and he'll want to put in a good performance. And on the other hand, he wants to get one over his old team. Strange old day for him today.
And fine work from Chelsea to win the ball back. He's showing a real will to win the ball. And the advantage is with PSG. They might be able to get in now. Thiago Silva's block. A PSG corner it is, and potentially an opportunity. Over it comes. And the goal kick will be next. Timo Werner. Take it away. Promising position here for Di Maria. And the referee has decided to award the free kick to PSG. No-nonsense clearance. Mount. Werner with it now. Can they do something positive on the counter-attack? And the ruling is offside here. Good-looking ball. There could be a chance now. Ideal for the goalkeeper, for any keeper. Mount. Well, he likes to run at them. Must take the lead here.
Enjoying the bulk of possession here. However, after that, the coach will be disappointed with what they've produced. They need to be a little bit more clinical in front of goal.
Mbappe. Ruben Neves. It was a menacing attack, but tidied up. And 1 minute of stoppage time has been added on. Was in the right place to intercept. The first half here comes to an end. Into the second half then, in this battle for Champions League glory. Successfully cut out. Mbappe. Ball lost by PSG. Werner. Possession changes hands, the interception there. Verratti. This is Neymar. Bernat. Mbappe. Tackle taken away. Timo Werner. Well, let's see what they have in store for them on the break. Look as though they might make real progress on the counter attack. Not so. They could pick out a teammate. And far from the ideal cross. Keeper's ball all the way. Oh, what's he gone and done? And the goalkeeper covered a lot of ground to push that away from danger. They've won the ball back quickly. It is a decent looking attack here. Cutting the ball back and able to close down the shots. James Maddison, and the counter-attack is on, options available, and the counter-attack came to nothing, and he read it well. Playing with purpose and control, opportunity, must be. Able to survive that attacking push. Mbappe. And Chelsea looking dangerous. And crossing towards the far post.
Absolute cracker.
It's going their way, 2-0.
Chelsea have struggled with possession a bit,
but they won't mind with that. They're winning this game. They're sucking their opponents onto them. And with the pace they've got in midfield and up front, they're really causing problems.
It has to be. And there it is. That will put the seal on victory if there were any lingering doubts.
Well, we can take another look at this now, and he's connected so well with it, generating a lot of power. And the keeper just can't react in time. Look.
Cross into the middle, just couldn't capitalize there. And Chelsea with the ball again. Bernat. Well, they've lost the ball. And just the 1 minute left in normal time here. Timo Werner. Mount. Tremendous. Chelsea have returned to the high altar of European football. Champions League winners.
Well, you have to say they deserve it as well. All those training sessions, that toil earlier in the season, 10 months of the season or so, and now they've got the rewards. Be respectful to the opposition as well. Make sure you congratulate them on a good final before you celebrate with your teammates.
A night these Chelsea players will never forget. Well, now for the official presentation. And as a footballer, Lee, in this case as a Chelsea footballer, this is exactly where you'd want to be.
Well, exactly, getting onto that podium. Huge amount of effort to get there, but this is the icing on the cake. Actually watching your captain pick the trophy up, sharing in that moment. It's a beautiful trophy as well, Derek.
It's Chelsea's moment. Champions League winners this season, and my goodness, they deserve it.
Brilliant moment. They'll be celebrating long into the night, I'm sure. And then, believe it or not, they'll be focusing the next few days on next season, no doubt.
That's how it works, but for now it's all about this achievement.
Well, this is the moment I love, sharing it with the fans. The ticker tapes coming down, the families in the stand, giving them all a wave. Well, they've travelled all over Europe watching this team. Now they get to share in this moment. Fantastic.
Well, it took fire as well as ice on the pitch. And now the players get to relax a bit and enjoy having the pictures taken.
Well, you know exactly where I'd be sitting in that photo, don't you, Derek?
I think I've heard it before, Lee.
Straight at the front.